It's Straitjacket Day here at Mucus Asylum Stadium here in Looneyapolis, Craziana, home of the Insane Colts. The first 1,000 fans will receive a free straitjacket and a 500-volt lobotomy.
Am I crazy, or did I just see a fan throw himself off the upper deck in a garbage can with an M80 in his mouth?
No, that's their mascot, Crazy Jimmy. Quite the entertainer, isn't he? Today's matchup is going to be complete mayhem. The teams are taking the field. Mutanteers take on the Insane Colts. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Say what? Come on, man. You can't hang with me. You get my grill, I'm gonna ruin your world. You understand me?
It's time to turn on, tune in, and get your mutant buzz on. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here. It's MFL Game Day, and you know what that means.
Yeah, the town will be in flames tonight, and half the city's population will be sliding down green street poles and eating all-you-can-eat horseshit buffets from the curb.
Yes, victory can be bittersweet sometimes, Bricks. Let's see if the home team can light up this town like a Roman candle. And it's first and 10.
First down! This guy just loves to hit people as hard as he can, Grim. I don't even think he knows what a first down is.
And it's first and 10. He had it for a second there. Second down and 10. He's sick when he should have zagged and ends up a shish kebab. And it's first and 10. It in there for a 4-yard gain. Second down and 6. Talk about butterfingers. He should have had that one. Third down and 6. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life.
Jenkins.
It's good. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and 10.
Not one.
Hey. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
Not one. Not two. Not three.
The bomb goes off, hurting no one.
Yeah, if a bomb don't kill anyone, does it still make a sound?
Sound. 1 yard on that pass. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he got it off. That's a decent punt. The return man catches the ball and heads upfield. Oh, with the brutal hit. And it's first and 10.
Shocked is no joke. I used to wear triple wool socks, slide around on a shag carpet for 8 hours so I could shock my younger brother. I went to change the TV channel and got blown across the room into the deer antlers.
Second down and 5. Third down and 6. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and 10. And with a burst of speed, he finds an opening and the first down. And it's first and 10. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one.
And he punched his way out of that, and the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And it's first and 10. And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe 2.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
Okay, nice and easy, like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. And then That's a great 9-yard completion there.
Hey, it ain't great if you don't score or move the chains.
And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. Scared of this guy, Bricks, and they have every right to be.
Yeah, he's a murderer!
And we've got a tight battle here as quarter one comes to an end.
Finally.
And it's 1st and 10. And that'll give him 4 more downs to punish the defense. And you better believe they will. And it's 1st and 10. That one was open downfield, so the QB threw the ball away. Second down and 10. And he reels that one in for a 1st down to keep the drive alive. And it's 1st and 10. Pick 6, but dropped the interception.
And that's why he's on defense, schmuck.
2nd down and 10. Nicely done for a 1st down. And it's 1st and 10. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. Gonna shave a few days off his life. Third down and 6. Get your motor running. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitting.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! It's 1st and 10.
Hot 1, hot 2.
And this guy looks like Thor on a revenge bender right now. And then he jars the ball loose, and it's a fumble. That's what happens when you hurdle and take a hard hit. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. You know, if you go frame by frame, you can see the cover of my son's death metal album.
Yeah, baby. Throw up the horns.
Oh, Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and ten.
Hot one.
And he's on the floor. He's dirty trick. This play is usually good for a quick score because no one can catch this guy. Look at him. He's like Speedy Gonzalez. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this.
Hot one. Hot two.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Third down and, well, good luck. And that is a big gain. You know the defense wants some payback after that. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he put all of his foot into that one. He's got the ball now and is going to try and... Oh, with the brain scrambler. And it's first and ten. Second down and more than the QB would like. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. First and ten. Three-yard catch on the play.
Every little bit counts. Those 3 yarders might grow up to be somebody one day.
The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have two left. Second down and seven. Third down and long. He runs it for three.
Timeouts aren't just for offense, Grim?
Well, they usually are, but sometimes the defense thinks they're helping out in their own special way. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
And he's got a chance for a good return here.
Ouch!
What is this, 80s wrestling?
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
Yeah, same as Rich's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Caught for the first down. And it's they stopped the clock, but they only have one timeout left.
That's okay, Grim. They can have nine.
That's nice, Bricks. But our timeouts are for our sponsors, and we need money more than they do.
I do.
First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open.
And timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Grim? You got to use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. And that's a catch for 3 yards. And that'll bring up second and one. Oh, he just got crushed. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. Welcome back. Hope you enjoyed the carnage during today's halftime show. Obviously, they need to play a lot harder here in the second half to make a game of it.
Or they can start cheating and killing. That's what I do.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Good throw, good catch, but not quite good enough at 9 yards. And that'll bring up second and one.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
He's not going down. And he'll pick up the first down with a nice piece of running there. And it's first and ten. And he'll pick up 7 yards on that play. Second and three.
Hot one. Hot two. Hot three.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
Second down and a lot. Oh, and he might have just saved a touchdown on that deflection. Third down and the punter is warming up.
Hot one, hot two.
Way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers, well, there's your answer, Bricks. Third down in the offense, and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Third down and forever.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
They run it for a yard. And they'll line up for the punt here. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. The return man catches, oh, with the punishing hit. And it's first and ten.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
Second down and two. Third down and three. Just follow the bloody footprints to the new line. That's a first down. And it's first and ten. Before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Second down and 10. Third down and, well, good luck. Knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a low with a brutal hit. First and ten.
Hot one.
Much like our wedding night, there was a big explosion, but then everyone left disappointed.
Everyone? You had more than two people in the room?
Yeah, the guy filming and the clown. Somebody's got to make the balloon animals.
And he runs it for 4 yards. Third down and six. They are going for it, and the defense is licking their mutant lips. Oh, man, what a throw. Blast just cleared the field for the receiver. Man, these guys are some high rollers, and they just won the pot. That's a first down. And it's first and ten. And the defense gives up 5 yards there. Second down and five. And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. They'll need to fire on all cylinders to make a comeback in the final quarter. And it's first and ten. And that is caught for a first down. First down and six.
Hot one, hot two.
And he catches it for a touchdown. What a beautiful play. This, they're going for two. And perfect pass for 2 points. That's a piece of art right there, Bricks.
Yeah, man. The QB turned the defense into an abject mess.
Oh,
home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and 10. Second down and 9. Quick, the quarterback blow up the defense today. He was right. Third down and 9. He blasts it and picks up 7 yards right there. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. And he snags the punt and looks for open field. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
They call the warp speed dirty trick. He's so fast he watches 60 minutes and 60 seconds. Second down and long. He was starting to go somewhere, but he gets stumped after 3.
They usually stop me after 3, too. You know, the all-you-can-eat buffets? They're not as literal as you'd think.
Third down and the punt. It's called a zap attack. The ball carrier better move his ass out of bounds before, and he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. Whoa, hold everything. Looks like there's a penalty on the play. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
That's a nice catch for 5 yards. Second down and 5. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. And it's first and 10. Nicely done for a first down. It's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
And he breaks away. A pickup of about 3 on that play. Second down and 7. Nice pickup for 6 yards. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Yeah.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It's good. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And it's first and 10. And he pulled out a chain shot. Now he's slicing and dicing his way through the defense. Time. Like a jack in the box, Bricks. You never know when one of those hot potatoes is gonna blow. You just crap your pants, Junior. And that'll bring us to the 2-minute warning. It's do or die now. Second down, the size of Bricks' wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. And that, and the defense calls the thunderclap dirty trick. Man, that's gotta hurt.
That'll make the hair on your corpse stand straight up.
They're stopping it for their own offense. They're hungry for the ball, partner.
The ball? The pigskin? Bacon! I'm hungry for bacon!
I'm pretty sure my baby sister can throw further than that, but she doesn't have to play against goddamn monsters.
The defense has to make something happen here with one timeout left. And that'll be second and 8 to go. Takes its final timeout. They can't stop the clock anymore, so they'll need to stop the offense. Third down and 10. And he's off to the races. The 10. They might catch him.
Move, you fat little mutant.
And the ref just called a bullshit penalty. Third down, and the offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Down and the offense needs a miracle. And that guy is dead.
Good riddance. He killed me in my fantasy game last week. I wanted to murder him myself.
The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass.
Yeah, well, at least they don't have to forfeit, man.
That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a 2-minute drill. Second down in a very lot. You've got to catch that. And the offense goes into the hurry-up formation to try to conserve time. First down! He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. No receivers open, so the QB just threw the ball away. And this field goal is certainly within the kicker's range. And a
cheered. It's good to be good, huh? I mean, can't we all just...
Not this shit again. Bricks, I'm stopping it right there.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And he just slipped away like a greased pig. The Colts walk away losers today.
They're losers every day in my book.
The opposition came into town and stole one from them. It's a bitter one-point loss.
Just like a thief in the night. They should go to jail. Stealing ain't right, Grim.
Let's listen to what the game's most valuable player has to say about it.
Why? The guy's got the intelligence of a horseshoe.
Once again, the folks at Evil as In thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it, so you...